facing the fallout of Liz Truss's visit, she poked the dragon, and so has America. What have the Americans done? They promised more weapons, among other things.
We're deepening our ties with ASEAN and the Quad. I'm pleased that the United States will soon provide significant additional security assistance to Taiwan through the presidential drawdown authority that Congress authorized last year.
As expected, China is livid. It has resorted to its usual temper tantrums. Taiwan says it tracked 9 Chinese military aircraft and 5 naval vessels around the island. This was between yesterday and today. And China's Ministry of National Defense issued this statement.
We would also like to make it clear to the DPP authorities and the separatist forces that any attempt to seek independence by soliciting U.S. support and by resorting to force will lead to nowhere. The Chinese People's Liberation Army will continue to strengthen military training and combat readiness, take all necessary measures to smash separatism in any form and external interference, and resolutely safeguard China's national sovereignty and territorial integrity.
He says China will do everything necessary to smash Taiwanese separatism. What does that mean? Well, so far it has involved conducting live fire drills around the island, especially after every high-profile diplomatic engagement, like former U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit last year, Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen's visit to America. She met with current House Speaker Kevin McCarthy. After both these incidents, Beijing went berserk. It increased the violations of Taiwanese airspace and littered the area around Taiwan with live ammunition. And it made a UN cry at international forums. Like I said, the usual temper tantrums. China is now likely to step up the aggressive posturing again. Not so much due to distrust. Beijing keeps downplaying her visit, also calling it Instagram diplomacy by the UK's shortest-serving prime minister. I mentioned this a while back. More than trust, it's US President Joe Biden that has riled China up. US Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin also said this yesterday.
Another force is by making sure that you have combat-credible capability and in investing in the things that we know that will provide us the edge in any kind of contest is the right thing to do. The right thing to do, and that includes, in some cases, moving things forward in theater, repositioning things. And so, I think it takes both of those approaches to have a complete deterrent capability.
The key phrase here is deterrent capability. The U.S. is trying to make the cost of invading Taiwan too high for China to consider. Reports say Biden is planning to approve the sale of $500 million worth of arms to Taiwan. This is on top of a $90 billion arms package that was previously approved but not delivered yet. This package includes Harpoon anti-ship missiles, Javelin and Stinger missiles, HIMARS rocket and missile launchers, and F-16 fighter jets. The U.S. says that the $90 billion delivery will be expedited. Also, 100 U.S. troops are scheduled to go to Taiwan. What more? Biden says they'll evaluate Taiwan's defense trading methods. China does not see it that way. Here's what Beijing has said.
For some time, the United States has been constantly stepping up its military collusion with Taiwan's Democratic Progressive Party by strengthening military ties and upgrading substantive relations, which shakes the foundation of China-U.S. relations and undermines peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait. The U.S. activities are totally wrong and dangerous. The Chinese side is strongly dissatisfied and resolutely opposed and has lodged solemn representations with the U.S. side.
Beijing says it is prepared to forcefully reunify Taiwan and the U.S. is vowed to defend Taiwan. These threats and statements have been flying around for a while now. They've turned the region into a powder keg. One wrong move could lead to disaster.
Try this 3-minute shower routine to quickly get rid of toenail fungus, itchy skin,